الحمد لله رب العالمين، والصلاة والسلام على أفضل المرسلين محمد وعلى آله وصحبه ومن تبع هداه بإحسان إلى يوم الدين. We will speak about التيمم today إن شاء الله رب العالمين. تيمم in English they say dry ablution. Let's call it التيمم. معنى كلمة التيمم does mean the tension here. Tension. In fact, the tayammum is not going to clean the body. It will fully clean the body. But the tayammum is not cleaning the body. That's why you have to have an intention to do the tayammum, and we're going to speak about it. المعنى الشرعي definition of the Islamic Sharia definition فهو القصد إلى الصعيد أي الرمل لمسح الوجه واليدين مع النية. Have the intention to go to strike the sand or the ground. The ground with the intention of tension. وذلك لاستباحة الصلاة. And that is the or to permission to pray. قليل من السنة وهي من خصائص أمة محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم فقط. Our deen. The tayammum only in the Islam. The Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم said, أعطيت خمسا لم يعطهن أحدا من الله عز وجل has given me five things. No prophet before me have those five things. And this is said the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم قل نصرت بالرعب مسيرة شهر. I have the victory if there is 1 month distance. 1 month in the horses going, the people will have the fear. Only from Prophet Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم. The other prophet, subhanAllah, the people, they used to run away from the people. The Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم. Number two, وجعلت لي الأرض مسجدا وطهورا. فأينما رجل من أمتي أدركته الصلاة فليصلي. And he said صلى الله عليه وسلم الأرض, Allah عز وجل had made the earth, the whole earth is for me مسجد and clean, طهورا. And whoever any man of my ummah, my people, have the time of the salah, that person should pray in Allah. Masjid and tahur. And this is only for the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, for the Islam. The other religion, they have to have a certain area, certain place only for salah, not any place. They cannot pray in the street. They have to go in the temple, praying on the temple. Number three, وَأُحُلِّتْ لِيَ الْغَنَائِمْ وَلَمْ تُحُلِّ لِأَحْدٍ مِنْ قَبْلِي. الغنائم, the bounties, the booties. All the booties is only for the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam in our deen. But before that, they used to put the booties, ghanaim, in a place, and that would be struck by lightning from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, would be burned. Before Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. وَعُطِيتُ الشَّفَاعَةَ Allah azza wa jalla, he gave the intercession of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. وَكَانَ النَّبِيُّ يُبْعَثُ فِي قَوْمِهِ خَاصَّةً وَبِعِثُ إِلَى النَّاسِ عَامَّةً حديث متفق عليه. And the Prophet before of me, he used to be sent only for specific people for his nation. But me, I was sent for all mankind. Five characteristics only for Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. But in the hadith, we concentrate with number two in this chapter. وَجُعْلِيَتْ لِيَ الْأَرْضِ مَسْجِدًا وَطَهُورًا الْأَرْضِ Allah عز وجل has made the earth is a masjid for the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So any place you can pray, of course, clean the place. وَطَهُورًا you can make also tayammum from the ground. Now this have a dalil from the Quran and from the Sunnah. And we spoke, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا لَا تَقْرَبُوا الصَّلَاةُ وَأَنْتُمْ سُكَارَى حَتَّى تَعْلَمُوا مَا تَقُولُونَ وَلَا جُنُبًا إِلَّا عَابِرِي سَبِيلٍ حَتَّى تَغْتَسِلُوا وَإِنْ كُنْتُمْ مَرْضَى أَوْ عَلَى سَفَرٍ أَوْ جَاءَ أَحَدٌ مِنْكُمْ مِنَ الْغَائِطِ أَوْ لَامَسْتُمُ النِّسَاءَ فَلَمْ تَجِدُوا مَاءً فَتَيَمَّمُوا صَعِيدًا طَيِّبًا فَامْسَحُوا بِوُجُوهِكُمْ وَأَيْدِيكُمْ إِنَّ اللَّهَ كَانَ عَفُوًّا غَفُورًا. آية الله سبحانه وتعالى says in سورة النساء of course we're not going to speak of the explanation and the tafsir of the ayah, but in the ayah Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says وَإِن كُنْتُمْ أَوْ عَلَى سَفَرٍ أَوْ جَاءَ أَحَدٌ مِنْكُمْ مِنَ الْغَائِطِ أَوْ لَامَسْتُمُ النِّسَاءَ فَلَمْ تَجِدُوا مَاءً فَتَيَمَّمُوا. This ayah subhanallah repeated because Aisha radiallahu ta'ala, I'm going to speak about it. Say Allah azza wa jalla say speaking to the believers, all believers, if a person sick or traveler or he used the bathroom, or that person have a relationship, intercourse relationship, and there is no water. تتيمموا يمين تتيمموا جراوند سعيدا طيبا، فامسحوا الله عز وجل ان فامسحوا بوجوهكم وايديكم، يو وايب يور فيس اند يو وايب يور هاند اند وي جونا هاو دو ذات. عن حديث الرسول صلى الله عليه وسلم من مسند احمد قال: جعلت لي الارض ولامتي مسجدا وطهورا، حينما ادركت رجلا مني من امتي صلى الله عليه وسلم said the earth is for me masjid place to pray and tahir and any where he is supposed to pray he pray in that area in that spot. Let's come to the ayah why Allah Azza wa Jalla revealed the ayah. And Allah just I want just to give attention to the revelation of this ayah. So sometimes we see something wrong or something disaster happened to the people, the ummah, and we say this is bad, but Allah Azza wa Jalla is the planner. When I was teaching geology in the college, and I said to us, when you speak about earthquakes or volcanic eruption, to us is disaster. Us earthquake and but without the earthquakes and the volcanoes, the volcanic eruption, the whole earth will be explosion there. Why? And the earthquake, subhanAllah, and the volcano make like stability on the earth. Otherwise, the whole earth will be gone. So the ayah revealed when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is revealed because of Aisha radiallahu ta'ala. Rawat Aisha radiallahu ta'ala. This hadith actually, Jama'a, Tirmidhi, and Nimaja, all them reported. Rawat Aisha qalat, kharajna ma'a al-Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, fi ba'da asfarihi, hatta idha kana bil-bayda. The Prophet, they say, we travel. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he used to make Qur'a. This is like lottery between his wives and take them with him, traveler, or take them with them for in the battlefield. And Aisha, she said, I was one of those. And I went with the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. But in qat'a uqdun li, in my bracelet was cut. And we didn't know where is the bracelet. فأقام النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم على التماسه وأقام الناس معه. Look at this. We learn something from it here also. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he was looking, find where is the bracelet. What is the bracelet? And when the Sahaba radiallahu anhu showed the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam looking, start to look with the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And that was the kind of the mercy of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Someone else would just like, how you lost it? How this and that? And would be very angry. But guess what? The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and the Sahaba radiallahu anhu, they got tired looking for the bracelet. Cannot find it. And when they did, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, there is no water. There is no water for the people to pray, no water to drink, there is no water. So there are some for the drink, but there is not enough for wudu. The Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم, he slept on the thigh of Aisha radiallahu ta'ala. Thigh of Aisha, without fighting an argument. And then Abu Bakr al-Siddiq came, and he didn't know what happened. And the Sahaba told Abu Bakr al-Siddiq, look what Aisha did. Look what she have done. And the Prophet, Abu Bakr al-Siddiq, he went to Aisha and he saw the Prophet ﷺ laying down on her thigh, sleeping. He came next to his daughter and like hit her, but with his finger. Poke her with her, yeah. I said, why you did this like this? Why you make everybody busy and no water now? Because everybody like delay looking for the bracelet. And then when the and she said, I hate to make sound, you have pain, make sound because the Prophet is sleeping on my thigh. Out of respect and love, subhanAllah. فقال فيما يمنعني من التحرك إلا مكان النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم because he was sleeping there على فخذي فنام حتى أصبح على غير ماء. But he woke up in the morning. أنزل الله سبحانه وتعالى الآية. الله عز وجل revealed the آية. As it's true, and the ayah is a lot of food that you guys yeah, listen to the ayah, subhanAllah, ya ayyuha alladhina amanu la taqrabu as-salah wa antum sukara. Of course, part of the ayah is mansukh. Part of the ayah is abrogated. And the rest of the ayah is not abrogated. That we, in ulum al-Qur'an, say, you can Allah Azza wa Jalla, he avoid or abrogate hukum or rule, but not all the ayah. The hukum, but not the ayah. لا تقربوا الصلاة وأنتم سكارى. Do not pray while you are drunk. حتى تعلموا ما تقولون. Unless if you know what you're talking about. ولا جنوبا إلا عابري إلا عابري. If you are جنوب, does mean have a sexual relationship, but you didn't make shower. حتى تغتسل. You have to take a shower. is another ruling here for the junub. وإن كنتم مرضى, but if you are sick, أو على السفر, or a traveler, أو جاء أحد من أحد منكم من الغائط, أو لامستم النساء, فلم تجدوا ماء. So all these rules, what is breaking the wudu and need ghusl. And you don't find water, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, فتيمموا صعيدا طيبا. In the tayammum. And Allah Azza wa Jalla explained how to make the tayammum. فامسحوا بوجوهكم وأيديكم, وإن الله بأيديكم only the hands. And we're going to speak about this difference between the ulama, what is the meaning of the hand and so on. Let's come to, and then subhanAllah, Usayd ibn Hudayr radiallahu ta'ala, Usayd ibn Hudayr, he is one, the first Muslim among the Ansar. The first Muslim among the Ansar in Al-Madinah, he was Usayd. And he said, subhanAllah, أول بركتهم يا آل أبي بكر. This is not the first one, Allah Azza wa Jalla plus this family, the family of Abu Bakr al-Siddiq, many things. Many things. One of this blessing, Allah Azza wa Jalla revealed this ayah. And guess what? Allah Azza wa Jalla revealed the ayah. The camel of Aisha stood up, and the camel stood up, they found the bracelet under the camel. They found the bracelet under the camel. And you can't believe Ali Salam tell the Prophet, where is the water and where is the bracelet? And that's it, you know, and let the people proceed. But no, brothers and sisters, no. Why? Because Allah Azza wa Jal first will make the hukum and look at the ayah, many ruling in the ayah, and we think it's bad. You remember, and subhanAllah, Aisha is very, very special, even for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, even special. This woman is very special. Surah An-Nur, when those people, Abdullah ibn Ubayy ibn Salul, accused her for adultery. Look at it. 11 ayah in Surah An-Nur. 11 ayah in Surah An-Nur, Allah subhanahu wa revealed because of Aisha radiallahu ta'ala until the day of judgment. We recited those ayahs until the day of judgment. Subhanallah Rabbil Alameen. So, let's proceed. Al-Asbab al-Mubiha al-Tayammum. When is the Tayammum is allowed? Not every time. Of course, in the book is around the three reasons, but I gathered around six reasons from different places for you. قد يباح التيمم المحدث حدثا أصغر أو أكبر في الحضر والسفر إذا وجد سبب من الأسباب الآتية. The تيمم, the one have no wudu and the one have a janaba. Janaba, even if he is a traveler or he is resident, he is home. For that person, he's allowed to make the tayammum with the following reasons. Number one, إذا لم يجد الماء أو وجد منه ما لا يكفيه للطهارة. If there is a water, if he cannot find the water, إن لم يجد الماء فعليه بتيمم. If there is no water, or there is water but there is not enough to make غسل and وضوء and everything. Do we have a دليل؟ Yes, عمران بن حصين رضي الله تعالى عن حديث البخاري المسلم متفق عليه. حديث عمران رضي الله تعالى عنه ابن حسين قال كنا مع النبي مع رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم. We were with the prophet with the messenger of Allah صلى الله عليه وسلم في سفر in traveler. فصلى بالناس. Look at this hadith, the mercy of the prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم, how he deal with his companions. صلى في الناس and he pray with the people. فإذا هو برجل معتزل. There is a man sitting in a corner by himself. فقال صلى الله عليه وسلم ما منعك أن تصلي, يعني أي معنى what will prevent you or stop you to not praying with us, pray by yourself. قال يا رسول الله أصابتني messenger of Allah, I have like a witty dream. And the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم قال عليك بالصلاة, only the soil is enough for you, so you don't have to take a shower عليه وسلم. So number one, if there is no water and or there is not enough for طهارة for غسل. Number two, إذا كان به جراحة أو مرض. If the person they have some wounds or sick وخاف من استعمال من الماء زيادة المرض أو تأخر الشفاء, you know, and the person he's sick and or some wound and he's afraid if he take the shower he will become more sick or the wound is not going to be cured fast, there is a reason. سواء بالتجربة, you know, either بالتجربة or from تجربة with the experience, something happened with the experience, or doctor trust worthy doctor. This is really brother. Tomorrow we are going to have a janazah for a baby. The baby inside the womb of the mother. He must clarify. And the doctor told the woman, you have to have an abortion. Yes, doctors, we believe in this science. But my understanding here, what I advise the brothers and the sisters, if one doctor said something like this, especially with the matter of abortion, we must clarify it from one or two and three trustworthy people. Trustworthy, not anyone. But let's come to the hadith. قال وَمَنْ طَبِيبُ الْثِقَةِ حديث جابر بن عبد الله الأنصاري رضي الله تعالى عنه. قال خرجنا في سفر فأصاب رجل منا حجر سجه في رأسه. We were traveling not with the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم, traveling by themselves. And one of the people, he got hit by a stone or rock in his head. And that person came very sick. But he is sleeping, فاحتلم. And he got a witty dream. فسأل أصحابه. He asked his companion, the companion of the Prophet, صلى الله عليه وسلم, of course, هل تجدون لي رخصة في التيمم? Have you find, do you have any a permission for me to make تيمم? فقالوا ما نجد لك رخصة. وأنت تقدر على الماء فاغتسل. Okay, we don't have a permission for you not to use the water, and there is water. And that man, he takes the shower. When he takes the shower, he die. Why? Because the water goes inside and making infection, and he die. But قال جابر said, فلما قدمنا على الرسول صلى الله عليه وسلم, when we came to the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم, أخبر بذلك. We told the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم about what happened. فقال قتلوه. They killed him. May Allah killed those people. And then, ألا سألوا إذا لم يعلموا? Did they ask if they didn't know? And this hadith of Bukhari and Muslim also. And he said صلى الله عليه وسلم, فإنما شفاء العي بالسؤال. العي عن الجهل. Say, what is the cure of the ignorant when the people ask? And they get the answer. إنما يكفيه أن يتيمم ويعصر أو يعصب على جرح خرقة ثم يمسح عليه ويغسل سائر جسده. He said the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم, is that enough for him, for that man, just to tie the injury, the wound, and then after that wash the body, but don't wash the area, just wipe on the with Jabira or the cover, whatever it is, just wipe, but don't wash. And that was the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم. So he understand from this hadith also, brothers, if the person have a cast, just wipe over the cast. You don't have to wash the cast. And even if the person put the cast while there is janaba, and then he broke his hand, his arm, something broke, and he went to the doctor and just make the cast. Still the person can wipe over the cast, even if there is janaba previously. It's not in his hand. And this deen is very simple, brothers and sisters. Number three, إذا كان الماء شديد البرودة وغلب على ظني حصول ضرر باستعماله وبشرط أن يعجز عن تسخينه ولو بالأجر حتى. إذا كان الماء شديد, if the water is very very cold, the water is very cold, and there is no way for that person to warm the water, even if he pay, he cannot warm the water, and that's good for that person only just to make tayammum. And this hadith, Amr ibn al-As, radiallahu ta'ala, and subhanAllah, he was a new Muslim. Amr, he was a new Muslim in that time. And Amr ibn al-As, he was, لما بعث في غزوة ذات السلاسل, he was the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم, immediately he sent him for the battle of, called ذات السلاسل. قال, احتلمت في ليلة شديدة. I was have a wet dream in very cold night. Very cold night. فأشفقت أن أهلك. And I was afraid or will die if I take a shower with the cold water. I will die. فتيممت. And he made the tayammum. Some sahaba, by the way, he got very angry. He said, you cannot do this. You have to take a shower. And Amr radiallahu anhu said, no, I'm not going to kill myself. But he was the imam because he was the amir of that group. And when they went to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, they told, and the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم قال يا عمر صليت بالناس لأصحابك وأنت جنوب يا عمر have you prayed as an imam with your companion, with the friends, and you are junub. And فقلت and now who Amr said, قال يا رسول الله, I heard you say the Prophet Allah Azza wa Jal says in Surah An-Nisa, ولا تقتلوا أنفسكم إن الله كان بكم رحيما. Don't kill yourself, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is merciful with you. And قال صلى الله عليه وسلم, حنا الحديث قال فضحك صلى الله عليه وسلم, الرسول صلى الله عليه وسلم smile. So and he didn't say anything. قال ولم يقل شيئا. In hadith said in Sahih al-Bukhari, قال the Prophet doesn't say anything. Does not say that your salah is not valid. Your salah it is not valid. It doesn't say that. And remember when in the beginning I said the hadith is three things. So hadith is three things. Sunnah is three things. Even the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم he did himself. We just imitate him, or whatever the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam he order, and we just follow the order, or whatever the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam he approved, and he approved the act of Amr radiallahu ta'ala anhu. So, and also this is one of the hadith. Number four, إذا كان الماء قريبا منه. Oh, he approved. He tasam. His approval. Al iqrar. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. What is the iqrar? إقرار السنة إذا إقرار الفعل أقر فعله بالإقرار he kept silent he did ولم يقل ذلك he smiled he asked the question but he didn't tell him no that's wrong if he said that's wrong that's it that's حكم that's rule is not there but the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم أقر ذلك he approved this then the Prophet that is ruling تك خالد remember خالد we spoke about أصول الحديث when خالد رضي الله عنه he ate the iguana The Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم approved it. That means the iguana is okay to eat. But the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم he doesn't like to eat it, but it's not haram. And this act also, Amr ibn al-As رضي الله تعالى عنه. Number four, إذا كان الماء قريبا منه, the water is close to or nearby, the water is nearby, but one cannot get it easy. You cannot get sources for that because of the afraid animal or army. Or a curfew, or anything. يخشى على نفسه الموت. يخشى. Then you're afraid if you get that water, you will get killed. So, or a person in a prison, for example, or jail. Maybe there is not enough water. You miss the tayammum, you don't use that water. Yeah. That's just allow tayammum. It's okay for the person to make the tayammum. Number five, إذا احتاج إلى الماء حالا. You need the water right now for cooking for إزالة نجاسة ليس معفو عنها is a lot of dirt نجاسة or impure area and you need the water from that spot to care for the person to do the جنازة to do the تيمم جائز له التيمم and this is really important having number six or the last one إذا كان قادرا على استعمال الماء لكنه خشي خروج الوقت باستعماله في الوضوء أو الغسل فإنه يتمم ويصلي ولا إعادة عليه. في he is able to use the water. There is water and he is able to use the water. But he is afraid if he used the water the time of the salah will pass. Time of the salah will pass. So that person it's okay for him to make tayammum تيمم and then he pray. This is really important point. Sometimes we are travelers, traveling, and we want to get to the plaza, for example, on the highway, we want to get to that plaza. And you see the sun is going down. So you stop the car, you make the tayammum, and that's it. Do you have to redo the salah again? No, you don't. Because you already did it last. You cannot pray two salah, twice for one farida. You cannot pray twice for one farida. Yeah. إقامة الصلاة it's fine. It's the time of the salah. The time passed. For example, Maghrib 8 o'clock, and you don't pray Asr. Okay. And don't make this 8 o'clock come pray. So don't go. Oh, I have to take shower or I have to make wudu. No, you make the tayammum when you come back. الإقامة is different. The إقامة because there is time to go make wudu and catch the salah. And still there is, even if you do pray jama'ah at all, that is not right. That is not right. Let's come to الصعيد الذي what can be used for تيمم. يجوز التيمم بالتراب طاهر. تيمم how we can make the تيمم with the sand or a rock or believe it or not the wall or gypsum and so on. Why, what is the دليل? Anything, what is the دليل? And I spoke about it with you before. الله عز وجل قال فتيمموا صعيدا طيبا. What is صعيد? قال أهل اللغة. And actually I went to the Arabic dictionary. قال أن الصعيد الطيب هو وجه الأرض ترابا وغيره. كلمة صعيد in Arabic language. Any وجه الأرض, the surface of the earth. The surface of the earth, تراب or sand, soil, or anything on the earth. Or anything else on the earth. That is the meaning of صعيد. And Allah عز وجل قال صعيدا طيبا means the surface of the earth. yes, تفضل. Yes, anything on the land, but it's not conditioned here. Why? Fine. Yes, because that's what my brother he is doing with the tayammum. He have a rock. And why? Because the Prophet, the issue is not, and I'll give you the proof how to make tayammum. The issue, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, when he told Anas radiallahu ta'ala anhu in the hadith, how to make it, قال, strike the ground and blow. But why he blow? Because he didn't want the dust go to the face of Anas radiallahu ta'ala anhu, the hadith. And we have this, and Bukhari and Muslim, متفق عليه, this hadith, say, it's not conditioned, a lot of people, they, and some madahib for your information. Imam Abu Hanifa, rahimahullah ta'ala, have dust, to condition. But if it is a condition, why he blow the dust? I want just to give a clear, as I mentioned it in the beginning, the tayammum is not for cleanliness. The tayammum, it is absolute, is not to clean, because you're not cleaning anything. In fact, you strike the ground, and might the ground to be is not clean. The issue, as I mentioned in chapter wudu, touch the place with Allah, where the Allah Azza wa Jal ordered you to do. Where Allah, for his wudu. Remember I said, if you put yourself in the ocean once, twice, three times, how many times you put yourself in the ocean? You're clean. Is that right or not? But do you have a wudu? Why? You don't touch the places, the areas of the wudu. You have a madhab al-Imam al-Shafi'i, but believe it or not, Kitab al-Umm, when we have it here, the chapter of wudu, the Imam al-Shafi'i, he mentioned to have gargar on nose, but still also, in the madhab, you know, you have to touch the places of the wudu. From a condition here. But at least, فَتَحُوا وُجُوهَكُمْ وَأَيْدِيَكُمْ إِلَى الْمَرَافِقِ فتحوا برؤوسكم ورجلكم إلى الكعبين. Yes. Let's go how to make تيمم. How to make تيمم. Number one is the النية. Just like wudu. Have to have the نية. Number two, هي remember في النية التي تميز العادة عن العبادة. النية make difference between the عادة, the custom, the tradition, and the عبادة, the worship. Fine. You don't have to say the niyyah. You don't have even to pronounce the niyyah. In fact, to pronounce the niyyah is a bid'ah. To pronounce, to say, نويت أصلي صلاة المغرب or نويت أصلي صلاة العشاء, that is a bid'ah. Why is a bid'ah? Because the Prophet never mentioned it. Abba never mentioned it. Tabi'in never mentioned it. النيّة محلها القلب. النيّة is the place in the heart, as we said. Number one, we said النيّة. Number two, تسمي بالله. Still you have to say Bismillah. Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam did so. Number three, ضرب الأرض باليدين وينفخ بهما. Say to strike the ground, the soil with your hands and blow. But if you don't want to blow, if you strike the wall and there is nothing in your hand, you don't have to blow your hands here. But we can take the hadith inshallah عن عمار, not أنا استغفر الله, عمار بن ياسر رضي الله تعالى عنه. عمار بن ياسر رضي الله تعالى عنهما, because the first شهيد الإسلام هو ياسر, the father of عمار رضي الله تعالى عنهما. قال أجنبت فلم أصب الماء. فتمعكت في الصعيد. And listen carefully here. Say, I have a wicked dream and I cannot find any water. And he just rolling himself on the sand. Rolling himself on the sand. The issue is not the cleanliness, as we said. And وصليت. And he prayed. فذكرت ذلك للنبي صلى الله عليه وسلم. And I mentioned this to the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم. فقال صلى الله عليه وسلم, إنما كان يكفيك هكذا. I said, what's enough for you? Just like this. And he says, صلى الله عليه وسلم, وضرب أنس, استغفر الله, عمار رضي الله تعالى عنه, he explained how. قال, وضرب النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم بكفيه. And he struck the ground with his hands. ونفخ بهما. And he blew on his hands, صلى الله عليه وسلم. ثم مسح بها وجهه. And he wiped his face. وكفيه. وكفيه. Only his hands. His hands. Huh? That's very good question. Yes. Only one strike. Do we have a difference between the scholars regarding this? The answer is absolutely yes. Like Imam Shafi'i, قال يجب أن strike three times. Strike three times. And not one only that. Please give me attention to Imam Shafi'i. You strike one, two, three. And then you wipe your face and do like this. Watch here. Put the hand, I don't know if it, the hand over here, and do like this, and like this, and like this, and like this, do like this. Abu Hanifa too. Yeah, but again, Malik hand actually, yeah, exactly. Malik twice. There's only the difference between Malik and the other with the only with the number of the strikes. Except Imam Ahmad ibn Hanbal rahimahullah ta'ala. I don't want some people to say, oh, you are Hanbali. No, I'm not. I'm Sunni. I am absolutely Sunni. Imam Ahmad ibn Hanbal, strike once, face and hands, and assalamu alaykum wa alaykum assalam, done deal. With what? With the intention and bismillah. Now, of course, I'm not going to go in details with that, but this is the Sunnah, inshallah. Of course. To follow Imam al-Shafi'i is correct and right, because there is some hadith with that too. And Imam Malik rahimullah is right, Imam Abu Hanifa is right, and Ahmad ibn Hanbal is right, inshallah, Rabbul Alameen, and also Ibrahim Dirmari is right. Because I follow the sunnah of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. What do we find the tayammum? ما يباح وما ينقض التيمم. ما ينقض الوضوء هو ينقض التيمم. Simple. What is a breaking the wudu? Nullifying the wudu is breaking and nullifying the tayammum. But there is some extra things here. And to make tayammum is not condition for the time to enter. Can you make wudu any time? Yes? All right, yes sir. Okay. You can make tayammum any time too. Okay? To pray only in tayammum farida and nafila. It's like wudu. To pray farida, to pray nafila is fine. لأنه حكم حكم الوضوء. The rules of this rule of وضوء. لقول أبو ذر الغفاري رضي الله تعالى عنه قال إن النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم قال إن الصعيد طهور المسلم. صعيد means the soil is a purification or طهور, that means for the Muslim. وإن لم يجد الماء 10 سنين. Even if you don't find the water for 10 years you can make the tayammum. فإذا وجد الماء فليلمسه بشرته فإن ذلك خير. You find the water, take the water now, touch your the body. We will speak about some points with that because it is really important. Now, what nullifying the wudu? I also, إذا وجد الماء بطل التيمم. بقاعدة شرعية. If there is a water, there is no more tayammum. But now, if you make tayammum صلاة الظهر and you find صلاة العصر water, صلاة العصر water, you have to redo الظهر. No, it's done deal, that's it. But you are in Zuhur, making tayammum, you make tayammum, and you are in Zuhur, and suddenly you saw the water. You continue or you cut the salah. You cut the salah. You cut the salah. Because إذا وجد الماء بطل التيمم وبطلت الصلاة بالتيمم هنا. Exactly. So you have to make, because you have to make wudu. There is actually the Imam Malik actually رحمه الله تعالى. You like Imam Malik, I know. Then Imam Malik رحمه الله تعالى says, ويكمل الصلاة. Imam Malik is there. You pray for example, in Imam Madhab Malik. You pray two rak'ah dhuhr. And suddenly somebody brought the water, or here there is the water. You go and make wudu, and you come. If you don't speak, you can continue your salah. Yeah? You finish up your salah. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala a'lam, you start from the beginning. Is more authentic. Is more authentic. Wallah subhanahu wa ta'ala a'lam. This is my name. Yeah. For the tayammum, is not conditioned to, for every salah. Tayammum, you can, whatever break the wudu, it breaks in the tayammum. So if you make for Fajr Salah, and you don't break the wudu, you make your tayammum in Fajr Salah, and Dhuhr, mashallah, you have wudu, and Asr, you have wudu. Because you don't drink this, you don't have to go to the bathroom. So you will have it, you will hold it. So alhamdulillah, then you can make Salah with this. It's not a problem. With one tayammum, you can pray five salawat. It's okay to do it. No, it is not. It's not okay to do it for every salah. It's easy because track one and two. Salaamu alaikum, alaikum as-salam. Yes, it is easy. But the Prophet never done that. So we should not exaggerate too much our ibadah. So the Prophet is better than me and you regarding this. And this is Hadith Umran, the one the Prophet ﷺ said, the one Umran ibn al-Husayn. And when the Prophet ﷺ, he told him, just make Sa'id, make Tayammum. And in fact, the Sahaba, radhiyallahu ta'ala alayhim, they found the water, believe it or not. They found the water, and the Prophet ﷺ said, idhab fa'afruh, he gave him the water, قال, go and just wash yourself with it. And even after, when they found the water, after they found the water, he made the Tayammum. So the question now, in Janabah, how I just do it? Don't do it like Ammar. What you do? Just make tayammum. The person have Janabah and there is no water, and you're traveling in a car or something like this, and there is no water. Tayammum, regular tayammum, face and hands. So how are you gonna clean the clothes? You mean? Oh yes, it is in fact. Yes. Many, إذا كان جافا. Many, if it is dry, you يفركه. Just sorry, you know. If this is still wet, yes, you can do that with the sand. Yes, do that with the sand. That's why the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم, we spoke about it actually in كتاب الطهارة. When إذا ولغ الإمام في إناء إذا ولغ الكلب في إناء أحدكم. فليقتلوا سبعا إحداهن بالتراب. Say if the dog licking one of the pots, you wash it seven times, and one of the seven, one with what? With sand. With. But not, this is not ruling for the clothes, by the way. Some people say, oh, I have to wash my clothes seven times. Except if you put it in the laundry, it will be 7,000 times. 7,000 times. So it's not the condition. The hadith, brothers and sisters, very clear. إِذَا وَلَغَ الْكَلْبِ فِي إِنَائِهِ إِنَائِهِ, that's in the pot. أَحَدِكُمْ. Some. All right, inshallah. Let's open the question, inshallah. I finish the chapter. Next week, inshallah, we might not going to have a lecture next week. I might be in Iowa. So we're going to speak about menstruation, with الحيض والنفاس. For the women, especially for the sisters. So you have to be, all of you here, except if you're not married. Are married. Okay. Inshallah. I'll stop here, take the question, inshallah, and online and here, inshallah.